Greetings and welcome to Skyline Update, what's up on the mountain. In this next half hour, we'll give you an update on some interesting things happening with the Pagoda, the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower, and Skyline Drive. So we're so glad that you're joining us. So please sit back and relax, put the remote aside, and let us give you an update, because so many people in our community care about what goes on up there. We're a group called Pagoda Skyline Incorporated. We're volunteers. We're an organization that's dedicated to restore and preserve and promote the Pagoda, the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower, and Skyline Drive, an absolutely beautiful area. If you'd like to call in and ask us any questions, please do so. The number to call in is area code 610-378-0426 and ask us any questions you might have. My name is Mike Reinert. I'm president of Pagoda Skyline Incorporated and blessed to be your host for this program. And I'd like to introduce you to the panel we have. We have Corrie Crupi, who's the chair of the board of Pagoda Skyline Incorporated.
Good evening.
And we also have Charlie Rampolla, who's the vice president of Pagoda Skyline. And Charlie has some video updates of what's going on at the tower. Also, we have a special guest this evening, L.T. James of the Pagoda Writers. And she has some interesting stories and pictures to show us. So we're going to have some fun here this evening. You know, this is a really interesting day. The day we're doing this program live is October 4th. October 4th is the biggest day of the year for CB radio enthusiasts. Did you know why? Because of the date. It's 10-4, good buddy. Okay? I just wanted to make sure you remembered that. I couldn't resist. I've been doing that all day and having too much fun with it. Anyway, we're glad that you're here for this Skyline update. And this is October, and it's a beautiful time of the year to be on the mountain. It's one of my favorite times of the year. And no matter how busy you are, how much work you have to do, how many bills you have to pay, whatever you have to squeeze into a day, you have to take a few minutes sometime, especially toward the end of October, and take a drive up onto the mountain. The foliage is an absolutely incredible tapestry, an explosion of colors. Take a drive up Hill Road, Angora Road, go up Skyline Drive if you like, or go down the back of the mountain on the List Road, and just absolutely enjoy the incredible array of autumn foliage that's exciting to see in October. Doesn't cost anything, too, just a few minutes of your time. Just an absolutely beautiful picture. One of the places I like to go is to go up Hill Road and then make a left and go north on Angora Road for just maybe an eighth of a mile. And there's a like an island of trees in the middle of an intersection of a road that takes you up to Duryea Drive. And each tree has a different color leaf in autumn. One's red, one's gold, one's orange. And it's one of the neat pictures to take. So just wanted to remind you, there's a lot of incredible scenery on the mountain any time of the year. It's also neat to catch the sunrises and sunsets from Skyline Drive. And if you can't do it in person, you can log on to our website, pagodaskyline.org. And you can see our webcams. We have one at the Pagoda and one on top of the fire tower that you can see the sunrise and the sunset. I brought a couple of pictures in that I took recently to share with you because, you know, taking in scenery from the Pagoda is a neat thing to do, especially at the end of the day. Here's a sunset, the sun going down and a little bit of cloud in the sky. Because you're looking west, you can really get a beautiful view of the sunset. This time of the year, the sun goes down between 6:30 and 7 p.m. if you'd like to come up and try to catch it with the Pagoda as a silhouette. Recently, I was also there as a storm was coming over. You can see the ominous dark clouds with a little sunshine coming through and the beams of light coming through. Also a neat thing to behold if you're up there. But make sure you have some shelter nearby, too, because it gets pretty windy. The Pagoda is open, by the way, weekend afternoons at this time of year, weekend afternoons, if you'd like to visit. You may have heard some talk also about the Mount Penn Preserve, a project to market the mountain as a destination for recreation, for businesses, for nonprofit groups, and for a lot of different activities. You'll probably see and hear more about that leading the effort of County Commissioner Kevin Barnhart and the Pagoda Foundation, Lee Olson as chair. Some grant money is being raised to try to promote the mountain as well as a destination. So stay tuned about that. Corrie Crupi always has an update of some interesting things, and you have a neat picture to share with us, too.
I do. See if you can see this picture. Okay.
Isn't that a neat picture of the pagoda in the fog?
Okay, let me get the right camera.
There we go. Okay.
Okay, there we go. All right. Yeah, this was a wonderful surprise for me this weekend. Friends and neighbors of mine, Sherry Wetzel, Andy Hecker, and Ashton Hecker, saw this picture and immediately thought about me. And I just thought it was so cool. They were visiting the Goggle Works this weekend and saw this photograph taken by J.M. Wrestler. And I just thought it was really awesome. I wanted to share it with you.
It is really neat to see. Sometimes you can see the mountain, but you can't see the pagoda or the tower on top of it because the cloud level and the fog can obscure it. So you know what it looked like before the pagoda and the tower were there. The William Penn Memorial Fire Tower was built in 1939. It was a WPA project. The pagoda was built in 1908. It's been there for over 100 years, but about 108 years to be exact. And that was built to replace a quarry that had been there. The original intention was to have the pagoda be a hotel, which didn't materialize, but the second owner donated it to the city in 1911, to the citizens, so they would preserve it. So here we are, and with many of you out there who help us with our fundraisers, who help us with our cleanups and some of our different projects. It was neat to see that. Thanks for bringing that in, Corrie.
Oh, yes, I appreciate it. I love it.
Charlie Rampolla is our vice president, and Charlie's been up hanging around the tower lately. And if you'd like to go up to the top of the tower, but you don't want to walk the 168 steps, you can do that right now. Charlie has some video from the parapet at the top.
That's right, Mike. I went up to last weekend. I went up to the tower, and I took this video so you don't have to walk to the top. And like you said before, you can also look at our webcams from the tower at pagodaskyline.org. And click on the bottom of the page, and there's a webcam, so you can see it right from your sofa. What I'm going to show you now is actually from last weekend. I walked around the parapet of the tower, which you can do, like Corrie said, you can call and schools can go up. It's by appointment, or we have it open one weekend a month. So I'll show you the video, and you can get an idea of what we're doing. Right now, I'm walking out the south door. There's four doors at the very top. We go out the south door. And as you can see, we're looking south at Never Sink Mountain and in the city below. And the very end of the video, we'll actually look at the pagoda, down from on the pagoda, which is can't see anywhere else but from the tower. Now we're looking west. Now we're looking west, and that's our weather station. And on our website, you can click on the weather. We have a under weather station. You can click on it, and it'll give you all the stats of the weather. Right now we're looking over the city towards Wyomissing. Reading High is right underneath us there. And if you keep looking, we'll actually look towards the airport right there, and you can see the runway. Now we're looking over towards Muhlenberg, Copperhead Hill there. Now we're looking north, and there's some of the antennas that are along Skyline Drive. Now we're actually looking towards Ole Valley, and we'll keep going east towards Philadelphia. And you can actually see the Limerick towers from the tower. Right now, you can see, there's Corrie's area, Stony Creek, and St. Lawrence, and now we're coming back around south again towards Never Sink Mountain.
Isn't it true, in a clear day, you can actually see Liberty One in Philadelphia to the southeast from the top of the tower?
Yes, you can. You can actually see the reflections. Now, actually, we'll be able to look down on the pagoda. You can see the pagoda there. This is one of the few places that you
there
can actually see the pagoda and the flag. It's the only place you'll be able to get this view, I guess, unless you're in a helicopter or plane.
Some of the trees start to change colors. Mm-hmm.
Yes, like Mike said, it's really beautiful up there, especially this time of year. So that was the pagoda from the tower. We actually watched that for the fireworks. And as you can see, here's Reading again. That's East Reading. And then I'll take you back inside the tower. and show you the spiral stairs that we walk up to get there. And Mike, we can say that our fundraising right now is to refurbish the stairs. They're in need of painting and sandblasting. Right here's the top part of the spiral stairs that you actually would climb.
And the tower itself is 120 feet tall, and there are 168 steps up to the top. And the base of the tower is about 1,120 feet above sea level. So when you're standing on top of the tower, you're 1,240 feet above sea level. It's an amazing view. Thank you for getting that video, Charlie. I appreciate
You're welcome,
it. Mike. We do have a caller, someone who is calling in to talk to us. Hello, and welcome to Skyline Update. Thank you for calling. And who is this on the phone?
Well, I hope it's me, Michael. This is Henrietta.
Hi, Henrietta.
And I'm one of the board members there, which you already know, but the other people don't know. And Owen and I have been very busy today. We were going around getting, I'm getting all mixed up. We're getting advertisement in this coming Sunday's Reading Eagle about our fundraiser, which we're trying very hard to get enough funds together to get the tower back in perfect shape. New bathrooms and new walls and just everything down there. When I say walls, I don't mean the tower. I'm talking about the walls that are along the roadway. And we're doing pretty good, and we have already gotten some funds in from different people in the local area, and we're hoping to hear from Taylor Swift. Wouldn't that be marvelous?
I understand you're trying to make a connection there.
Yes, I certainly, we are, not just me. But anyway, I just wanted to say to the folks that are listening in, we're going to have this ad in the paper, in Sunday's Sunday paper. And also, for all you folks that get the fish wrapper, we're going to have an ad in there Thanksgiving week. So look for that, and then you might just be able to help us out.
I appreciate it. Henrietta and her friend Owen have done a wonderful job of raising some resources that we need for the tower, and particularly for the steps, too. And we appreciate that, Henrietta, and appreciate your calling, and let us know if you do make a connection with Taylor Swift, because you can see why missing from the tower, and I know she grew up there, because I have pictures of her when she was a little girl, and her parents, Scott and Andrew, are wonderful people, and I'm just so happy for their success. So
I remember you showed me that picture. They look like two little angels there.
Indeed.
And listen here, Mike, I just wanted to say, 10-4,
good buddy.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks for calling.
See you later.
All right,
bye.
Thank you.
I do want to thank Henrietta Ziegler and Owen Bieber for their efforts. They've been working tirelessly to try to get some funds in for the tower for some repairs that we need to make, specifically what you had talked about, redoing the stairs and sandblasting and it's going to take a lot of money. So look for the ads, the Sunday's paper, and then in the fish wrapper the week before Thanksgiving. And maybe you can donate. Every little bit helps.
Every little bit helps.
It does.
I've heard that before. And you know, I just realized something. You know, Henrietta Ziegler and her friend Owen Bieber. You don't suppose Owen's any relation to Justin Bieber? That would be a really good connection for a donation. All right, we'll have to work on that. You know, one of the things you might be saying is, why are we making such a big fuss about the tower? The tower is an important part of our skyline, too, not just because it's historic and because it's there, but it has a very practical purpose. It is a working, operational fire observation tower. The Department of the DCNR, the Department of Conservation and Natural Resources, uses it, and the firefighters at Lower Alsis and throughout the area use it for forest fire observation. When you're up high looking down on the fire, you can better spot exactly where it is and what lane to get to fight it. So it is used by the firefighting community, as well as if anyone would like to tour it as a group to learn about the history of the WPA area in the 1930s, or just to go up and enjoy the view. So the tower is a very important part of our skyline. We also have a very important guest here, and Corrie, this is a friend of yours, and maybe you'd like to introduce LT.
All right. Well, tonight we have the pleasure of having LT James with us. She is a fellow Central Catholic High School graduate with me, and class is 75. And Linda is the volunteer coordinator for Pagoda Writers. And they meet at the Pagoda the first Saturday of each month, weather permitting. And I think it's 1 o'clock are your meetings. So I'm going to let Linda tell you about what the Pagoda Writers can offer to you.
Hello, everyone. The Pagoda Writers has been in existence for between 6 and 10 years. And when I started volunteering to coordinate it, we started with 3 people. I was there, the manager of the Pagoda, and our speaker. And now we have close to 300 on our email contact list. So it's a wonderful group of diverse people, all ages, all backgrounds, all professionals in their own right. And we come together to inspire each other and to encourage writing. So we've had all ages, from a 7-year-old little boy who wrote a story about a donut going into outer space, and he named his donut Glaze. And I thought that was the best name for a donut anyway, because I love donuts too. But he came to our group with his mom, he brought his mom with him, and one of the writers from the Eagle wanted to interview him for a story in the Eagle. So we've also had people in their 90s and hundreds to come and share their stories. And I wanted to just encourage everybody, all students in the Reading area, Berks County area, and beyond, to give it a try. Come up, go to pagodawriters.com, our website, and give me a call, 610-413-0373. If you have any questions, you can sign up. Because we're all inclusive. You know, it doesn't matter if you've never written a word before in your life. You can come and learn. And I've seen people come and say, well, I'm not a writer, I'm not a poet. And within a few months, they come with a prepared manuscript. And they're on their way to being published. So please come up, give yourself a try. Even if you have no interest in writing at all, the stories you hear are pretty amazing. Everything from fiction to true stories. So please come. You're all invited. And I wanted to also let you know Corrie is going to be speaking on Saturday at 1 o'clock, October 8th. And she's going to be telling stories about the mountain and dressing up in a character that she talks about. So it should be quite fun. We go from 1 to 3 at the Pagoda, the room above the gift shop. So if you're interested, please call me or just come. And you're more than welcome. One of the reasons I got involved with the Pagoda Writers is because about 10 years ago, I was going through the attic drawer after my mom passed away. Her name was Mary Jane Painter Thompson. And I found this whole drawer full of memorabilia that had been sitting in the attic drawer for over 70 years. She served in World War II in the OSS, which is the Office of Strategic Services, which is now the CIA. So she was sent to North Africa and Italy after boot camp and training in Washington, D.C. She trained as a cryptographer, and her story is amazing. And some of these pictures you see here in front of me just inspired me to encourage everybody to write and learn more about their past. Or, you know, everybody has a story to tell, and everybody has gifts to share with each other. So if you don't think you have something, look back into your family history. And if you have a veteran in your family history, or friends or neighbors, we are also having a workshop November 5th, which we're honoring veterans because the next Friday is Veterans Day. So we encourage all veterans and their families to come up and hear 2 of our great speakers coming to talk about their stories. One is from Washington, D.C., and the other one works with Covenant Care up on 61, Route 61. And they both have some great stories to share. And we want to honor our veterans here in Berks County and beyond, because without them, our country would be in quite sad shape. Some of these photos are quite unique. This one shows my mom as the only woman in the photograph in front of the Vatican. Along with her, all her male counterparts in the OSS during World War II. She served from 1943 to 1945. Came home and finished her degree at Albright College, and she was the editor of the Q yearbook that year and was involved in many, many activities at Albright. That was her dream. She grew up on Perkiomen Avenue near Pandora Park and loved that area. There's a picture of her here. There's Pandora, the Lindbergh Viaduct above Pandora Park. So all you kids that play there at Pandora, there's a huge history behind this area. She went to Hawk Elementary, Southern, Reading High School. Here's a picture of Mom and her friends at Reading High School, the castle on the hill. You can see the building right there. So all the students at Reading High, you all have stories to tell. And no matter what your challenges are in life, you can write them down and you can overcome them. And you're all welcome to come to the Pagoda Writers this Saturday and hear Corrie, and come back every month, because each workshop just builds on another. And by the time you know it, you'll be writing up a storm. Thank you so much.
And thank you, L.T. James, for coming to share with us. Like what you said, we all have stories to tell.
We do.
And that's really what writing is about, isn't it? It's telling stories that will inspire others to develop their own story. So it was nice to have you here. And if you're interested in the Pagoda Writers, please reach out to L.T. And if you're interested more about Pagoda Skyline, or you'd like to be a volunteer for Pagoda Skyline Incorporated, don't forget to connect with us. You can get on our website at pagodaskyline.org. And by the way, we also like to test your knowledge about the skyline. So we like to conclude the program with a TQ quiz, a tower quiz. Let's see what you know about the tower, your tower quotient. Okay, here's a question with four selections. See if you can tell the right answer. The William Penn Memorial Fire Tower was built in 1939 by, was it A, William Whitman, B, William Penn IV, C, the WPA, or D, Bob the Builder? Who built the tower? Okay, all right, well, we can start with a process of elimination. Bob the Builder, he came much later. He's popular with the kids. So it wasn't D, Bob the Builder. Was it built by William Whitman? If you answered A, you were close. William Whitman had the pagoda built, but not the tower. Was it built by William Penn IV? No, it was named after William Penn, but not built by the Penn family. The answer is C. It was built by the WPA. It was a project of the WPA in 1939, where the government gave people jobs. They didn't make a lot of money, but they had jobs, and it helped get some people through the Depression. The Skyline Drive Wall was a WPA project, and so was the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower. So I thought that might be a nice piece of history for you to know about the tower. By the way, back to the Pagoda. It is open weekend afternoon. Stop by our Pagoda Skyline all-volunteer operator gift shop and do some early Christmas holiday shopping while you're there. And stop by and say hi to Audrey and her volunteers. And also the Pagoda Cafe is open. Say hi to Cindy and Scott and their volunteers. That's operated by the Pagoda Foundation, which we also support, that is operating the Pagoda. So we have a nice partnership of a lot of volunteers trying to preserve the mountain and its landmarks. So I want to thank you for watching and thank our panel, Corrie Crupi, who's the board chair of Pagoda Skyline Incorporated. Thank you to Charlie Rampolla, who's our vice president. And thank you to L.T. James of the Pagoda Writers for telling us about your mother and some of your stories and inviting the rest of us to tell our stories. We want to thank you, our donors, and thank our volunteers. We want to thank everybody who supports the mountain. And we want to thank our members and everyone here at BCTV for giving us this forum. And we want to thank you for your interest. I'm Mike Reinert. On behalf of everyone at Pagoda Skyline Incorporated, I want to say thank you again. God bless you all, and we'll see you next time.